Hey everyone, Cody from Mac Telecom Networks. In this video, we're going to be checking out the Ingenious ECW260 Outdoor Wi-Fi 6 Access Point. This access point is IP67 weather rating, and I want to thank Ingenious for sending this to me to do a review on. If you're new here, please hit the subscribe button. Make sure to hit the bell icon. If you'd like to hire me for network consulting, visit www.mactelecomnetworks.com. You'd find us on Instagram at Mac Telecom Networks. And we have a Discord server and an Amazon storefront. I'll put the links in the description below. Like always, let's see what comes with the ECW260. First up, we have the ECW260 access point. This access point is Wi-Fi 6 and has spots for 4 external antennas. On the top of our access point, we have our weatherproof grommet, which we could just screw off. And on the inside of the access point, we have a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet interface. This access point is powered by PoE and does not come with a PoE injector. On the back, this is where we're going to be putting our mounting bracket. I'm going to mount this onto the back of my fence where I have another switch outside. And then we have a slot for our grounding screw. It comes with 4 antennas. 2 of them are 2.4 gigahertz antennas and the other 2 are the 5 gigahertz antennas. It comes with 2 mounting rings if we were going to put this onto a pole. It also comes with some of these metal anchors if we're going to be putting it into drywall. Here is our mounting bracket, which we'll be using to put onto my fence. And it comes with the grounding cable, which is great. We won't be grounding it for this video as I'm using it just for testing. And most likely this access point won't be staying in my backyard. On the top of the access points, we could see it says 5 gigahertz and 2.4 gigahertz. So we need to put the antennas in the right spot. So let's put the antennas on. I'm going to grab my 5 gigahertz antenna and then we'll just screw it on. We'll do the same for the 2.4 gigahertz and then we'll do the bottom antennas. Now let's go back to the computer, look over some of the specs, then we'll get this mounted and do some testing. Now that we've seen what comes in the box, let's see some of the specs for the ECW260. So we could have dual concurrent 802.11ax and backwards compatible with 11ac, A, B, G, and N. It supports up to 1200 megabits per second on the 5 gigahertz band, and 574 megabits per second on the 2.4 gigahertz band. It's IP67 rated weatherproof and dustproof, and we have that 2.5 gigabit Ethernet interface that's powered by the PoE Plus. As you've seen, we have 4 2x2 detachable 5 dBi, high gain 360 SMA type antennas. This access point is managed by the Ingenious Cloud, and it supports mesh wireless networks. There's a bunch of different prices I found for this access point, but from StreakWave, you could find it for $488 USD MSRP. I did find it around $350 USD MSRP as well. I've already mounted the access point to the back of my fence, and at the back of my fence, it's this huge open field where they're going to be building. Now we're going to go to the Ingenious Cloud, get this into our controller, and create an SSID. After that, I'll do some testing where I walk back into the field and see how far we could go, do some speed tests, and do some iPerf tests. Now we're at the Ingenious Cloud controller login. The Ingenious Cloud is license-free network management. We'll click on the login button. And if you've already signed up for this, you could put your email and your password in, or you could sign in through Google, Facebook, or AE Partner. If you don't have an account, you could sign up in the top right corner. I've already signed up. I'm gonna put in my credentials, then we'll get into the controller. Now we're at the Ingenious Cloud dashboard, and we could see that it shows switches, access points, and clients, as well as the internet. We have no devices registered right now, and we need to register our ECW260. How to register a device? We go to the bottom, and then we go to inventory and license. We can see that there is no devices registered on this cloud controller, and we'll click on register device. There's a couple ways we could register the device. We can manually put in the serial number, or we could scan the QR code on the back of the access point. I'm just gonna enter the serial number manually. Once we have the serial number in, we just need to press register and then press done. Now we could see that our access point has registered to the controller. We could go up to our little computer icon and then go to access points. We could see that there's no access points currently on here, but we could add from inventory. And in our inventory, we could now see that the ECW260 is showing up. We could click on it and then press apply. Now the device is in our controller, we could see a bunch of information. We could see the name, the serial, the MAC address, the model number, the channels that it's on, so it's on channel 8 and 36 right now, the WAN IP address, which will show up as your public IP, the LAN IP that it's getting from DHCP, clients, the firmware, which there is a firmware update, It shows the uptime and last updated. If we click on the device, we could go to details and we could reboot or we could replace. Let's look at some of the details. So we have quite a bit of information here. We have all the same things on the last page, and then we could update our firmware, which we could toggle on and off the LED. And then we could look at the SSID information, which we haven't created any yet. Below, we could see our throughput and by all SSIDs, or you could filter it out to just be one SSID. Now, if we want to change the channels and the transmit power of the access point, we could do that. Set to auto, but we could unlock the 2.4 or the 5 gigahertz, and then we could switch it from the auto channel and put it to whichever channel we'd like. Same with the TX throughput, the minimum bitrate, the client limit, the channel width, and then discard 11AB or G, and we have that disabled. I'll just leave everything on auto. We have some mesh settings, so it says enabled radio. Don't allow this AP to join a mesh network. We only have the one AP anyway, so it won't be meshing. And then we have our IP addressing. So this is getting a DHCP address from my firewall. You can put it static if you'd like, and you could also attach a picture. We have some log information for the access point, and then we could look at our clients, which we don't have any clients on here yet. So what we need to do now is create an SSID for this outdoor access point. We'll go up to the left at the config wheel, and then we'll go to SSID. Here we can see there's no SSIDs available, and we'll add an SSID. We're going to give it a name of Wi-Fi 6 test, and as we create the name, the QR code is going to change to match that Wi-Fi access QR code. So we'll call it Wi-Fi 6 test. We're going to have the SSID enabled. We're not going to hide it, and we're going to have it on the 2.4 and the 5 gigahertz band. There's a couple different security types we could use. We could have it open, WPA2 pre-shared key, WPA3 pre-shared key. We could have it mixed, or we could have WPA2 or WPA3 enterprise. We're going to leave it on WPA2 pre-shared key, and I'll put a pre-shared key of test 1234. If you wanted to put this SSID on a VLAN, you could do so, and there's a few other settings, but I'm going to leave the rest at default and press apply. Now back on the details tab of the access point, we could see that it's taken the new SSID Wi-Fi 6 test. So what we're gonna do now, I'm gonna grab my iPhone 11. We're gonna go into the back and do some speed tests, see how well this access point performs. I went out to the back and I did some speed tests, and the results weren't so good. So from 20 feet away, I was getting 56.8 download and 65.6 upload. I have a 1 gigabit symmetrical connection coming into my house. From 50 feet away, I got 28.3 down and 48.1 up. And from 100 feet away, I got 17.4 down and 23.61 upload. When I was about 130 feet away from the access point, my connection completely dropped. If you're not looking for high speed, just some basic network connection, this access point would be good for you. But at a price point over $400 USD MSRP, I'm not too sure it's worth it. I'm going to mess around with the configuration to see if I could get the performance up on this access point. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button. If you're new here, please subscribe and hit the bell icon. All right, thanks.